Kyle, and that was Trua showing off their size, speed, power, and problem-solving abilities. These behaviors keep our whales active and engaged. SeaWorld's killer whales have inspired generations to care about our natural world, and today we're excited to share their story with all of you.
Killer whales are the ocean's top predator. They use cooperation and communication.
44 years old. Tina is the matriarch, or the leader of our pod. Our whales trust us, and they take an active role in their own health and well-being. Through positive reinforcement training techniques, we teach them husbandry or healthcare behaviors. One of the first things that we teach our whales to do is called a fluke present, where they present their tail flukes to a trainer. We're going to demonstrate with Trua and Mikhail here in a slide up in just a second. But not only does a fluke present allow us to get a great look at their entire body, but it also is going to give us access to blood vessels, which are very easy to see on the white underside of their tail flukes. Our veterinarians collect a voluntary blood sample at least once a month from our whales, and the whales are taught to stay calm and relaxed throughout. So you can see Joe and Kristen are giving the whales the signal to ask them to turn ventral or upside down, and they'll present their tail flukes just like this. Now, throughout today's presentation, you'll see us giving the whales tail rubs, massages on their backs, bellies, even rubs on their flippers. They have very sensitive skin, and this is a great way for us to reinforce exceptional behavior and for us to build our relationships with our killer whales. Now, blood samples are just one way that we can make sure that our whales are staying healthy. Another important diagnostic is weighing the whales. We weigh them every other week, and we're able to do that by asking them to slide their bodies up and out of the water onto a killer whale size scale that we have in one of our adjacent pools. Mikhail on the left is our smallest guy. He weighs about 4,100 pounds. This is Trua on the right. He's our biggest guy. He weighs about 6,200 pounds. And both boys are still growing. But you'll notice that the portion of their bodies from their dorsal fins to their tail flukes, it's in the water. It's a very strong body part called their peduncle, and it weighs several hundred pounds. So with that in the water, we really get an accurate weight. To solve that problem, we simply ask the whales to lift their tails up and out of the water. Nice job, guys. This way, we can make sure that our younger whales continue to grow and our adult whales maintain a healthy body. SeaWorld's research and observation of the killer whales in our care has shed light on many of the mysteries about these amazing animals. For example, we know that the gestation period of a pregnant killer whale is about 17 months. That's information that would be impossible to obtain out of all of you, it's time to get wet!
Woo-hoo!
Thank you.
Oh, geez.
Yeah.
killer whale family showing off their incredible size, speed, power, and complex learning abilities. These behaviors keep our whales active and engaged. SeaWorld's killer whales have inspired generations to care for our natural world. We are excited to share their story with you today.
Killer whales are the ocean's top predator. They use cooperation and communication, not just size and strength, to take their place at the top of the ocean's food. At the bottom are small animals, like krill.
Nice job, everybody. Now this behavior is called a breach. Killer whales not only breach to get a better look around, but more often than not, they breach to show off. So when Kyle's making his way 40 feet down,
oh my God.
He's gonna take that turn and come show off.
Woo!
Come on, my cock, come on, girl. are excited to share their story with all of you here today.
Killer whales are the ocean's top predators. They use cooperation and communication, not just size and strength, to take their place at the top of the ocean's food. At the bottom are small animals, like krill. At the top, the apex predator, the killer whale.
Our matriarch and leader at 44 years old. Next, we have our two females, Nalani and Malia. Last but not least, our two males, Trua and Makaya. And the whales trust us, and they take an active role in their own health and well-being. So think about when you go to the doctor, and your doctor asks you for a blood sample. You know to hold out your arm, and your doctor will take that blood sample from the inside of your elbow. You're trained to help the doctor help you take care of your body. It's the same thing with our whales. But killer whales don't have elbows like you and I do, so we had to get a little bit creative. Now here I'm joined by Nick, Megan, and Nick, and their whales Katina, Milani, and Malia. Now they've asked our females to flip over onto their back and present us with the underside of their tail flukes. Now there's a vein that runs along the center of each lobe of their tail flukes. This is a perfect place for us to be able to collect that blood sample. Now not only is this so important for the health and well-being of our killer whales, but we can share this information with scientists and researchers that are studying killer whales out in the ocean. Now you'll notice as trainers, we are constantly giving our whales nice, big back, tail, and even flipper rubs. Now the killer whales have very sensitive skin, not only is this a great way for us to get a good look at their entire bodies, it's an excellent way for us to build our relationships with them as well. Now another important diagnostic tool, not only are those blood samples, but again, something you're all trained for. You know to step onto a scale to see how much you weigh. Well, in one of our adjacent pools, we have a killer whale size scale that our whales are trained to slide their entire bodies up onto, as we're going to be simulating for you here in our slide out. Yeah! Woo-hoo! All right, now take a look. Oh, Katina's jumping the gun a little bit. Now, Lani, Malia, and Katina, from their dorsal fins all the way down to their tail flukes, is a very muscular part of their bodies. It's called their pinnacle, and it can weigh several hundred pounds. And by them keeping their tails in the water, we would be missing out on all of that weight. We can ask our females to lift their bodies up and out of the water. Woo! And just like this, is how our females would be able to weigh themselves. Now we weigh our younger whales to make sure they're growing properly, and our older killer whales to make sure they're maintaining a healthy weight.
And the care isn't just physical. Mental stimulation and play are vital. We surprise and engage with our whales in every opportunity. Play is how killer whales teach their young to hunt. And for the adults, play is important too. It seems that they just enjoy having fun. Making time for play is an important part of life for killer whales.
Yeah! Well, observational learning and mimicry play a critical role in the killer whale's lives. And from the moment they're born, they'll learn by watching their mothers play and follow the leader with other whales. Alright, think we're the already? Excellent. Alright, take those two hands high above your head. But for all of you, it means it's time.